So you build a project to solve a problem, and one of the problems I have is I live in a fairly hilly area, and I need that little extra something to get up a hill. So here's what I did. So I took a fairly small car and just did an engine swap, because you never can have enough engines. That's about right. It was a Canadian market 1987 Pontiac Firefly. Was a turbo model, 1 liter, 3-cylinder, but you know what? I just need a little more grunt. And with a Sawzall and a welder, I can now get up pretty much any hill that I come across. Cool designs with it. It's converted rear-wheel drive, so the back axle's in there. I put a roll cage in it because I like to run my local hill climbs and drag strip. And yeah. Converted rear-wheel drive, got the original exhaust coming out the original hole for that extra sleeper effect, and yeah, we got plates. The biggest issue with putting 5 pounds of engine in a 1 pound bag is packaging. I wanted to keep the thing on a low budget, so I wanted to use as much of the Firebird as I possibly could. So in the suspension, I was going to use the Firebird front end in its entirety, but the lower control arms didn't fit, so I had to fabricate my own control arms. But then with the spindle and the front suspension, the shocks would end up where the engine was, so I bought some Chevy S10 front spindles and upper control arms, but the upper control arms wouldn't fit, so I had to fabricate my own upper control arms. But then, to make it all work and not hit a bump and steer itself into the ditch, I would have had to narrow the steering rack about a foot, which then isn't really much of a steering rack. So I cut it all out of the car, put in the Chevette steering, and then redesigned all the control arms to fit with the steering. And that was, I guess, the third or fourth suspension design to happen there. The Firebird uses a torque arm from the back axle to the back of the transmission, but that doesn't fit. I originally designed it to fit in here, but then there'd be no room for seats. There is no room. So it ended up being a four-link suspension because it fit, but I lose the back seat. Here in Canada, you need a heater. So way under here, I do have a heater core, 3D printed an adapter. It's got a computer case fan. This is a heater core, and it blows hot air up onto the dash for defrost. Not much left of the glove box because there's engine behind that. Not a lot of foot room in here for the driver. That's where your gas pedal used to be, that's where the brake pedal used to be, that's where the clutch pedal used to be, and that's where your foot now goes. So it's an automatic because you don't have room for three pedals in here. To keep it under the budget, the radiator's from a scrap heap, but it had plastic tanks on it. The plastic tanks split, so I fabricated my own upper and lower tanks, my own fan shroud, my own fan bracket. I don't remember what the fan's out of, and weld it all together, and runs absolutely slick. Electronics are all here, easy to get to if you have to maintain it, except the ignition system, which is way back in here. Tell me that's fun to get to. Oh yeah. Firefly's gas tank used to be under the back seat and filled here, but there's no room under the back seat because there is no back seat, and that's just rear suspension. So it's moved here. I cut out a square and then traced that square over to there, cut out the fuel filler door, rewelded it here, put the patch over there, blah, 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 moved it back to fast, and so yeah, fuel filler's right there in all of its original equipment glory in a completely different place. It still uses the factory GM fuel injection computer, so it's all factory and original equipment reliable. How cool is that? So it actually drives really good on the street. It's pretty stable, it's pretty nice, it's like pretty innocent looking on the street. It's a little sketchy in the rain, so you gotta drive it kind of gentle, and you don't want to drive it in snow, let's be honest. I got stuck on the flat in my driveway with so little snow you could still see the driveway underneath the snow, but in the dry, it's a lot of fun, so yeah.